Hey guys, it's Carla from Bon Appetit. I'm here today in my home kitchen and I'm getting all geared up for Cinco de Mayo. I'm going to be putting together a Cointreau original margarita, but first I'm gonna get my friend Rick Martinez on the phone who's down in Mexico and we're gonna put together some drinks and snacks and just have a virtual happy hour together.
Carla!
Hola Rick, ¿qué tal?
Bien, bien. I see you put your party shirt on.
I did.
Very nice, like it.
You're like Fire Island end of July tan.
I know. I've decided actually this is like my normal color.
What we're doing, I've like recommended to all these people who are like, how can I connect with my loved ones over food during the thing? And I'm like, pick out a recipe and like plan to do it and then make your thing and then like get together and eat together.
This is an essential part of my quarantine living now. So you go cook your things and I'll go make my things.
Check back in like 20.
Perfect.
All right, so now I'm gonna get my Cointreau original margarita going. I love this recipe because it is such a classic and it is also so simple and so easy to memorize. Have to make a margarita with fresh lime juice. This recipe's been around since the 40s, unchanged, and I think it's perfect in these proportions. 1 ounce of fresh lime juice, 1 ounce of Cointreau, got some silver tequila, 2 ounces. That's everything you need. And that is my workout for the day. I'm gonna use a little bit of lime. Just get the edge of my glass wet. And this is just a shallow plate with kosher salt. Oh my God, it smells so good. A little fresh lime in the glass. Drop that guy in. Oh, I think she's perfect. The original margarita. Oh my God, it's perfect.
I'm in Mazatlan, Mexico, and one of the things that are really amazing here are the berries, and I think they're gonna go really well with Cointreau. It's distilled from sweet and bitter orange peels, which make it highly aromatic, but gives it a unique and balanced flavor. The great thing about Cointreau is you can mix it with just about any type of liquor, and it's gonna make a better cocktail. Oh, it smells so good. Okay, so I'm gonna use 1 1/4 ounces. Just pour that in. Next, I'm going to use tequila reposado. So in Carla's original margarita recipe, she used tequila blanco. It's really crisp, it's really clean, whereas the reposado is aged. So it's got a little bit of a distinctive, kind of oaky flavor. That's what's so great about the original margarita recipe, Cointreau, tequila, and lime, is that it's incredibly riffable. It's so easy to just add your own personality and your flair with whatever you want to create. My little key lime squeezer. All right, and I want 3/4 ounce. I'm now going to put a chili de árbol, and I'm gonna take the stem off, give it a little bit of a crush if you like. I've got a sprig of mint, just throw that in, and 4 blackberries. And you don't have to muddle this, the ice is gonna do all the work for you. Make sure that this is securely fastened. You don't want cocktail to go everywhere. Now, you wanna take your chilled salted glass. Oh, look at that color. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. And that is a mora picoso, a spicy blackberry margarita. Oh, it is so incredibly delicious.
Okay, so now I'm going to get set up to make Rick's salsa de árbol. I love this salsa because it actually just uses mostly pantry ingredients. First thing I need is a couple cloves of garlic. And chili de árbol are beautiful, bright red, dried chilies, super easy to find. 3 tablespoons of olive oil. 1, 2, I think that's 3. Get that over medium high. Another thing I like about this recipe is that you grate the garlic. It smells really good already. So these are my fire roasted tomatoes. These have like a delicious smoky flavor. They're a little bit charred. And I'm also gonna add a cup of water. If we didn't have the additional water, it would just get too thick. Okay, so my salsa has cooled down and the last step is to add just a couple tablespoons of fresh lime juice. Stir that in. Give this a quick taste. Spicy and smoky and really fresh and limey. Oh, I'm excited.
So I'm gonna be making BA's Best Guacamole. I'm using a white onion. You don't actually need a lot of it. You only need about a quarter. I'm gonna use a serrano pepper. I usually use an entire pepper and then leave the seeds in, but if you're really averse to heat, then I would definitely take the seeds out. Give a little rough chop to my cilantro. The avocados here are so amazing. Like, they're always this beautiful and this green. I always start with a garlic clove and a little salt, maybe like half a teaspoon. And then just go in and give it a smash. Add my avocado. You just wanna give it a little rough smash. Make sure that you scrape the bottom of the bowl, because all of that garlic and that salt is down there as well. You wanna make sure you get all of that. I've got some beautiful key limes. And I'm gonna add about 2 tablespoons. I will give it a little taste. It's really good. I'm just gonna add in the herbs, and that is BA's Best Guacamole. I'm gonna have another sip of my margarita, and we'll be talking to Carla real soon. Carla!
I made my margie.
Oh, wow, it looks so good.
I made your salsa.
Oh my, that is a big bowl. Yum. I don't know if you can see this, like without dumping it on the hair.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Chicharron, some delicious totopos, and some BA Best Guacamole.
Unbelievable.
I've been here in Mazatlan for a little over a month now.
Yeah.
And the blackberries are just always present. And so I was like, you know what? Blackberries and a margarita, yes, sign me up.
Yum.
The Cointreau really balances things out.
Yeah, it sounds like you made a very creative margarita. I made the original margarita and now have Cointreau in the house, which, like, not only will I be making margaritas, but so many other drinks. It's so essential to have in the home bar. So what do you normally say on Cinco de Mayo?
Salud, dinero y amor, y tiempo para disfrutarlo.
Okay. Salud.
Salud.
Salud. Love you, Rick.
Love you too.
Mwah. See you.